obviously one of the weirder fight weeks that we've ever had in recent memory. Can you give us any insight as to what was happening behind the scenes all week?
Yeah, I mean, we were trying to keep this fight alive and make sure that it happened, and we couldn't have done it without a guy like Vettori. Vettori acted like an absolute professional, stud, you know, a guy that's incredible to work with this week. That's why this fight happened.
What about the flip side with Paulo Costa? I mean, we asked him earlier in the week when he said he couldn't make weight. We said, what happened? He's like, well, I'll tell you guys afterward. Sounds like we're not going to see him tonight. So can you tell us why he was unable to make weight, I should say?
No. I mean, your guess is as good as mine. Yeah, we don't know. Came in and did what he did. But with that being said, the guy fought his ass off tonight, you know. He didn't at the end of the first round, I didn't know if he was going to make it to the end of the second round as far as gas, but he fought his ass off tonight. He showed up and fought hard, so.
Was there ever a point in time where it was going to be 195 pounds? Because we heard first it was going to be 195, and then we hear, no, now it's 205. So, I mean, were there different agreements along the way?
Yeah, I mean, it started at 85, and we worked our way up to 205. but and again, you have to give all the credit to Vettori. You know, this guy was willing to fight at any weight, and he didn't let any of this stuff mess with his head. And you know, and at the end of the day, you know, it's all about the fight. They both fought their ass off. Costa came out and fought. Costa looked better the fifth round than he did the first round, so he was definitely in shape. You know, when a guy comes in and he's that heavy, you have to question whether he's in shape or not. You know, he was in shape.